In this quick video tutorial, I'll guide you how to delete documents and data from iPhone, iPad, iCloud as well as Safari web browser. You will also come to know about differences between deleting documents and data and offloading apps on iPhone. Hello everyone, I'm Rahul from techreport.com, and after watching this video, you will be able to free up a space from your iPhone or iPad simply by deleting documents and data. Before we jump into a step-by-step tutorial to learn how to delete documents and data from iPhone, let's learn what is documents and data. Every iOS application works in a sandbox environment, which means each iOS application has its own individual storage. These storages are stored in an individual folder named Documents and Data. Each app has a separate Documents and Data folder where it contains its app cache data, login credentials, message history, notifications, and other app-related data. Now that you know what is documents and data on iPhone or iPad, let's learn how to delete documents and data from iPhone or iPad. The easiest way to delete documents and data from iPhone or iPad is by deleting the individual app and reinstalling the app. This may not be convenient for every application, but it is surely good for a few applications accumulating most of the documents and data storage. However, installing large applications may eat up your internet bandwidth, and that's why I don't recommend it. You should avoid this method, especially if you have an internet connection with limited data bandwidth. Now, if you want to learn a cost-efficient way to delete documents and data on iPhone or iPad, this is how you do it. First of all, go to Settings and then General Settings and tap on iPhone Storage. If you are on iPad, this will be iPad Storage. Here you will see a list of applications installed on your iPhone or iPad. This will also contain more details about the individual app, like last use information and storage space taken by the app. Larger the space an application occupies, higher it will be placed. Tap on the app for which you want to delete documents and data. Here you will see details about app size and the size of documents and data stored by this app. You will also get two options: offload app and delete app. If you offload an app, this will temporarily delete the app to free up space taken by that app, but will keep its documents and data. So offloading an app won't delete its documents and data. However, deleting app does delete documents and data of that app. Now tap on delete app and confirm deletion. That's how you can delete documents and data from iPhone or iPad. You need to follow the same process with other apps as well, for which you want to delete documents and data. Even if you delete documents and data from iPhone or iPad, some apps might save documents and data in iCloud. To delete documents and data from iCloud, go to Settings and tap on Profile Picture next to your Apple ID. Now, tap on iCloud. This will show you details about your iCloud storage along with a list of various apps using your iCloud space. Tap on Manage Storage and choose the app for which you want to delete documents and data from iCloud. Now, you will see the size of documents and data stored on iCloud by that application along with various files the app has stored on iCloud. Tap Delete Documents and Data and followed by a confirmation to delete these documents and data from your iCloud account. But this will permanently delete documents and data of that app from iCloud, so make sure this data is not so important for you. If it is important, avoid deleting. You might lose crucial files and important work within that app. You can repeat the same process for every other app for which you want to delete documents and data from iCloud. Apart from documents and data stored on your device local storage and on iCloud, the Safari web browser on your iPhone or iPad also stores documents and data. This contains login info, offline ready reading list, browsing history, and other website caches for websites you visit regularly. In order to check documents and data stored by Safari web browser, you can tap on General in Settings, followed by iPhone Storage. Scroll down until you find Safari, and once you find it, tap on it. Here you will see the documents and data stored by Safari web browser. Now tap on Website Data, and this will show you a list of websites you frequently visit along with data stored by each of them. Simply tap on Remove All Website Data located on the bottom and tap Remove Now for confirmation. That's how you delete documents and data associated with Safari web browser. Please note that deleting offline ready content won't remove any item from your reading list. Instead, it will remove from offline ready content only. Hope this video was helpful. If you encounter any problem while deleting documents and data to free up space from iPhone, let me know in the comments below and I'll be happy to help. If you found this video helpful, please hit the like button and share with your friends. Also, don't forget to subscribe to TechRepro channel if you don't want to miss any update. We bring cool tips, tricks and review videos like this one. Thanks for watching. This is Rahul signing off and I'll see you in the next video.